हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज लेसन टू स्किपिंग शूज। दिस इज अ स्टोरी ऑफ एडवेंचर एंड इमेजिनेशन। लेट मी स्टार्ट अवर रीडिंग एंड एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द टेक्स्ट। केटी डज नॉट लाइक टू हेल्प अदर्स। कैन एनीवन हेल्प हर माइंड हर सेल्फिश वे? रीड दिस इंटरेस्टिंग फेरी टेल बाय द अमेरिकन ऑथर लूसिया मे एलकॉट, best known for the children's classic Little Women, and find out what happens when Kitty finds herself wearing a pair of magical shoes. In this, we are going to read a story where there is a one girl, Kitty, and she is selfish girl, and what will happen in the story, let we learn. Once there was a girl named Kitty who did not want to do what people asked her to do. Instant, she grumbled, "I won't, I can't." There is a girl, Kitty. She is a stubborn girl. She is not ready to accept the words of others, and she always put some excuses. One day, she was given a pair of shiny new shoes, and barely had Kitty put them on than her mother called. As soon as she put the shoes, mother called her. Kitty ran and tell the cook to make a pie for dinner, and she demanded to her mother to make a pie. "I don't want to," winked Kitty as usual, but the shoes gave one jump and swept her downstairs into the kitchen. Breathless, she gave the message and stared at the shoes, their bright buttons seeming to wink at her. What happened? She was forced to do the work, and she was jumping and moving very fast, and that was because of her shoes. Just then her father said, "Kitty, go to the post office before school and get my letter." "I can't," started Kitty, but away went the shoes, trotting briskly and going against her will down the street. "I will take these horrid rough shoes off as soon as I get home," said Kitty. And she was very stubborn. She said herself that shoes is forcing her to do the work which is not agree to do. She is moving against her will because of the shoes she was wearing, and now she is going out to herself as she took the letters. Soon she came to a bridge where she wanted to stop and watch a boat, forgetting school. When she was out, she was forgetting her school, and she was moving without any purpose and her father's letters. But the shoes went on walking, although Kitty held on the railing as hard as she could. She opposed, but shoes moved on. Finally, she gave up and found herself walking swiftly home, and quickly she is moving towards home. Back home, Kitty found that as hard as she tried, the shoes just wouldn't come out. But shoe is forcing her against her will. "Time for school," called Mama from upstairs. Before she could say, "I want," the magic shoes whisked her up. What is the meaning of whisked her up? Taken her up to the school. At break time, a girl knocked down the house of corn cobs she had built and made her angry. "Now I will kick your down, Dolly." Up went her foot, but it didn't come out down. It stayed in the air as if she were going to dance. The children laughed, and finally she said to Dolly, "Never mind, I will forgive you. Shoes is not working against her." Then the foot went down and Kitty understood how SOOS worked. They were cooperative when she was kind and good, but stubborn when she wanted to be naughty. To check this, when one of the boys' ball bounced over the hedge, she said kindly. Here, hedge means thicket of grasses. Stubborn here means referring to the move and firm steps she is taking. In this way, she understood the SOOS is working for the helping of other people, and it is not working against the destruction or any activity which is not good. Now, see, little by little, Kitty understood the SOOS is working for the help and cooperation of the other people. Now, she was Kitty wants actually to check her presumption that what she is thinking is right or not. Then what happened? Next paragraph. Perhaps I can get it for you, Willie. The SOOS lightly lifted her over the high hedges. How could you do it? Cried the surprised boys. Boys were surprised because she is a girl and she is helping them. Kitty laughed and began to dance, pleased that there was a good sight of the SOOS after all. She knew that SOOS will help her. She twirled, spinned, and twisted with pretty air bounds. What is the meaning of air bounds? Light and delicate steps she moves in for help them. Her feet bewitched. What is the meaning of bewitched? Under the magic spell, helping her. The girls were charmed and tried to imitate her, but no one could, and she danced till the bell rang. When Kitty reached home, her sister said, "Run and pick some strawberries for lunch." And without any argument, what happened? "I am too tired," she said, but the SOOS landed her in middle of the strawberries. And it was against the will of her. She said she was tired, but SOOS was ready to do work, and it moves her out from her home. With one step, she reached in the strawberry bed with one jump. Once the dish was filled, Kitty wanted to stay and eat a few strawberries, but she was zipped away into the dining room. Zipped away, rushed off. Speedily she moved back to home. "It's delightful to have a quick, earnest girl," said her mother. Earnest girl means who is very quick in work and fetching the things from the place, different places. "Will you carry a few bundles of some poor people later?" "Must I?" sighed Kitty. And Kitty said, "May I?" While the SOOS stepped under the table, reminding her that she must, whether she liked it or not, she has to do it against her will. SOOS reminding her, "It would be kind, but you may do as you choose," replied Mama. Mama said, "You, it will be a kind thing if you go and do this work." Kitty sat very still. She was deciding whether she would go pleasantly or by whisked sweeping about against her will. She finally said cheerfully, "I will go, Mama, and later may I come back through Fairyland?" And she took the permission also to enjoy the Fairyland, the place where tall ferns grow in the forest, where she can enjoy the safe time which she have had in her disposal. She wants to enjoy in the Fairyland. Permission was happily granted, and Kitty trotted means move away with a basket in one hand, a bundle in the other. Once she had given the stick baby some clothes, the lame girl books, and the old woman money, she felt happy, as people always do when they do kind things. People help others when they have things they do charity and give things to the poor people. Kitty soon reached Fairyland, after which was filled with wood flowers, forest flowers. Kitty wished to rest her aching feet, and immediately her feet folded under her, and she sat on a cushion of moss, green plant. Moss means green plant. Then with a thud, a large black cricket landed beside her, staring at her curiously. One cricket is there, one insect is there, sitting beside her, and that insect was watching her very curiously. That girl is sitting in the fairyland. Hello, are you related to my cousin Grasshopper? You took such long leaps just like him, croaked the cricket. Cricket asked the girl, you are sitting in the third sound like my grasshopper. He is my cousin. So you are having some relation with it? I am not a grasshopper, but the kitty replied, I am not a grasshopper, but I have on magical shoes today. I am putting some magical shoes, answered Kitty, surprised that she understood what the cricket said. And she was surprised also, because she talked one insect, and it is very surprising for her. Now she realized, it is a midsummer day and fairies play pranks today, he said. The cricket told her that it is a midsummer day today and it is a fairies play. The magic will stay till sunset and then the fun will be over because of the shoes. You can understand me and also those squirrels, frogs and butterflies. All the animals, insects, you can understand the language of those animals, and we understand your language and you understand our language. Sure enough, Kitty heard all sorts of voices singing, laughing, and she understood every word. Every word she understood. She talked and played with the squirrels and butterflies until tea time. She continues with those insects in fairyland. Just as the clock struck four, away went the shoes over the pool, the hill and the road, till Kitty reached home. With the shoes, she reached home quickly back. The sun will soon set. I must skip while I can, thought Kitty. Once tea was done, she was thinking to jump again. She waltzed, means here danced. Waltzed means danced. ठीक है, around the lawn so prettily that her mother exclaimed, she shall go to dancing school. Her mother said, she is a good dancer and she must go to some dancing school to learn dance. Kitty skipped on, hopping, jumping, to learn some graceful steps before the day was done, before the day was over. Finally, her mother called, stop now, dear, and run up to bed. It is a day over. Now you stop dancing and moving here and there. Go and sleep. A few minutes more, began Kitty. Kitty argued to play more, but was off like a flash. But those moments went by quickly into the bed, and she went into the bedroom. Soon the sun was gone, day was over, and the shoes became common ones. For midsummer day was over. Now the day is over, magic is over, and she is in her bed. Kitty never forgot the lessons she had learned, but Kitty remembered those lessons of that midsummer day. She ran errand quickly, willingly, remembered the pretty steps, whatever she learned, and often thought of the interesting creatures in fairyland. She also remembered those creatures in jungle, in forest. Whenever she was allowed to play with them, she hurriedly away quickly, as if she still wore the magic skipping shoes, and she wants to go there, she wants to talk to them and she feels that she is having escaping shoes which help her to make a good relation with those creatures. She wants to talk to them, she wants to enjoy the company of those animals in the forest, in the fairyland. In this way, we learn the importance of the Midsummer Day, the skipping shoes, which made the girl obedient girl, because she was not ready to follow the instructions of her elders. She was grumbling always, but because of the magic shoes, skipping shoes, she learned the importance of obedience, and she learned the importance of work in her life. And that day onwards, she follow and she do the work for the people. Thank you. This is an explanation of lesson 2, Skipping Shoes. In next video, we shall cover the question answers and other activities of this lesson. Go through this lesson once again, twice or thrice, and then solve the exercises in next video.